no-nonsense gin drinking. All gin and a surprising amount of nonsense. Hello, gin lovers! Welcome back! I'm Bobby Freeman, and today, my friends, we have a treat on the show for you. Don't know why I did it in such a high-pitched voice, but, you know, I enjoyed it. Now, many of you may remember about a year ago, I think it was this time last year, I tried Highclere Castle Gin, right, and it blew me away. Changed the way I drink gin. Well, it didn't really change the way I drink gin. I drink it in the same way, kind of like that. But what it did do is blow all the other gins away, because it was literally, not only was it the best gin of last year, it got my number one of the top 10 gins of last year, it was the best gin I think I've ever tasted, and my go-to gin. I refuse to at any point in time be without a bottle of it in my house. It's that good. Well, my friends, I have exciting news, because they have brought out a limited edition, and as you can see, it is gold. So let me introduce you to my friends, this little fellow, which goes by the name of Highclere Castle Barrel Aged Gin. Now, this little fellow, by the way, first of all, I should just declare that I've actually been saying the name wrong, I think, because funnily enough, the other night, me and Narissa were watching a documentary about Highclere Castle, and I always thought it was Highclere, as I just said, but it's actually Highclere, which makes sense, because E-R-E, so clear. So apologies for that, and I shall be rectifying that from now on. And the reason they have brought out this limited edition, this limited run of their gin, is because it's to celebrate the 100th anniversary of the discovering of Tutankhamun, or the tomb of Tutankhamun, the tomb in which he was, you know, found. Now, you might be thinking to yourselves, well, that's all well and good and very interesting, but what's that got to do with this gin? Well, Lord Carnarvon, who is the Lord of Highclere Castle, the owner of Highclere Castle, his great, I don't know how many greats it is, but one of his great, I'm going to go for five. Great, there we go, I'm good at math. Grandfather actually discovered Tutankhamun. Imagine that. He's the guy that discovered it. And there is a lovely, as I say, I've been to a bit of a day trip there, and they've got like a museum of it in the bottom, in the basement, and it's all very interesting. And that's why they have brought out this wonderful gold version, which I am very, very, very excited to try for you, my friends, today. So then, enough fanning about, let's find out a bit about it on the website, shall we? To commemorate the 100th anniversary of the discovery of Tutankhamun, you know what, hang on a minute, this is not right, I can't do this. I cannot read about such an exquisite gin from such a, you know, an illustrious place as Highclere Castle, just dressed in commoner's rags. So, let me try something a little bit more quintessentially English. Ah, that's more like it. What? To commemorate the 100th anniversary of the discovery of the tomb of Tutankhamun, bloody moustache is coming off, by Howard Carter. Oh, bloody thing's fallen off. By Howard Carter, the 5th Earl of Carnarvon, Highclere Castle Spirits has released a limited edition barrel-aged Highclere Castle gin. I say! Made with Highclere botanicals and aged in French Armagnac casks, ooh, my favourite type of cask, Scotch and American whiskey barrels with notes of honey, smoke and citrus. Bloody good job, old chap. With only 2,000 cases produced, this special blend of Highclere Castle gin is a once-in-a-lifetime product. Good lord. And like the discovery of King Tut's tomb, will go down in history, never to be released again. By Jove! Tally-ho! What? So, my friends, as you can probably tell, I am spectacularly excited about this. The phone cover's gone over, that's always a good sign. Now, this moustache is not long for this world, as you can probably tell, but we're just going to stick with it, see how it goes, and once it's gone, it's gone. So then, let's crack it. I mean, and by the way, can we just take a moment? Look at that bottle. That is it. Look at all this stuff on the side, reference to Tutankhamun and all that, all the Egypti, is that a word? I don't know. Egypti type stuff on the sides. It truly looks like something absolutely extraordinary. So, my friends, let's crack her open. Oh, my God. It seems a shame to kind of even crack the top, but I'm going to do it anyway. So, here we go. Now, then, I'm reliably informed by incredibly wise people at Highclere Castle that this is best enjoyed on the rocks. And, well, that you would think, having that prior knowledge that I have, I would have prepared some, but I've forgotten. Give me one second. Right, here we go. Whack some of those in there. As you can see, I've departed from my traditional gin glass as well today. I've gone in rather one of these, I don't know, I call it a whiskey glass, I suppose it is, because it seemed appropriate. So then, let's have a look. Now, the question on everyone's lips, including my own, is it going to be slightly kind of golden in colour? And I would imagine, yes, it probably is. Look at that! Look at that, my friends! Oh, swilling it around. I've gone quite mad. Sorry, I'll try to compose myself. Now, how? Now, is this moustache going to work? I'll keep it on. I'll see how... Oh, hang on a minute. I didn't do the sniff test. I was reminded just now that I haven't done the sniff test because, my God. Wow, gin lovers. Wow. Oh, my God. Sorry, I can't do that. I'm going to have to take my moustache off for a bit because it's detracting from my otherwise professional persona. Oh, my God, Jim. That... Amazing. So, as you remember before, the smell was one of the first things that got me of the original Highclere Castle Gin. Apology if I'm still saying Highclere. I'm trying to sort of trying to shift my brain to get around that. As we know, this uses obviously the Highclere Castle, the original recipe, as a base for it, and it's still got all that gorgeous kind of beautiful sort of balanced flavors, all botanicals of course from Highclere Castle Estate, but there's something new in there, obviously, as you would expect. Oh, it's just a hint of that kind of whisky kind of aroma. Because, and as I say, they've not mixed it with whisky. They've clearly just had it in the whisky barrel. So it's a tiny tinge of that has infused into that already wonderful Highclere gin. But as they said, wasn't there like citrus, honey and smoke in there? Aren't they like the three most wonderful things you could possibly imagine. If only everything tasted a little bit more like citrus, honey and smoke. But as I say, it's just a tiny tinge of it, not enough to kind of mask that wonderful Highclere Castle Gin aroma, which was excellent. And now, I don't mind telling you, I'm not usually a whiskey or a bourbon drinker, so this is going to be fascinating for me, because you never know, this could be a gateway into that whole new world. I don't know. But anyway, I think it's about high time. I've smelled it, I've talked about it, I've found it out. It is high time for a bit of a Highclere Castle, if you like. Nice little segue there. To get into the old mouth. So once again, thank you to all my patrons and my members who are supporting this show and paying for the gin on the show. You are wonderful. I say, ladies and gentlemen, this is a truly a one-off for this show, because these are only a limited edition. There's not going to be many. Once they're gone, they're gone. So I'm very excited about this. This is Highclere Castle, what's it called again? Barrel aged gin. I say to you all, cheers. Give it a swill round first, there we go. Oh my God. Wow, gin lovers, that's something special. Now, as I said before, I'm not a huge whiskey drinker, so I was a little bit worried about this. I was a little bit kind of, is this going to be my thing or not? But as I say, it's not really a whiskey. It's just a tiny tinge of whiskey. A whiskey has come along and just dipped its toe delicately into the original, my beloved Highclere Castle Gin. Which sounds okay in itself, but it literally just kind of just flavors it, as I say, with a tinge. I believe a tinge, I talked about this last week. Tinge is just a little something around the edge, a tinge of kind of whiskiness. But that on its own, perhaps wouldn't have been, to use a British phrase, my cup of tea. However, with the use of that citrus and the smokiness, I think the citrus, because I, as I said, I don't really drink whiskey, but I have had an old fashioned before, because they use a lot of orange and citrus in there. And I think citrusy, for someone who doesn't, is not a hardcore whiskey drinker, kind of beautifully offsets it and makes it much more palatable. And that's what they've done here. But again, used absolutely expertly and exquisitely, and making a wonderful, wonderful balance of flavors, which, to be honest, that's what I loved about one of the things I loved about the original Highclere Castle Gin was the balancing of those flavors. You can almost not discern them. They're so perfectly lined, like a harmony. And I did wonder if they were going to be able to do that by introducing, you know, such a different kind of flavor to it. But my God, they've even done it when they whacked a bit of a whiskey essence in there as well. It's quite spectacular. It's also a little bit stronger as well. The other one was 43.5, I think. I haven't actually got it here because I always keep it in the house because I'm always drinking it, but it's 43.5. This one's gone up to 45.0, and you can really taste that extra bit. It burns. That's the main difference, I'd say. It's warm. It's much warmer, as you expect with that whiskey essence. It's warm as it goes down the throat, but it's not too warm. It's not, you know, blow your throat out warm. It just gives, especially, you know, it's the end of December here in the UK. I have no heating in my studio and it's freezing in here. So any type of warmth is gratefully received. However, the best thing, which I was really, really hoping it retained, was one of the reasons why Highclere was my number ones last year, it's got that silky smoothness about it. Highclere Castle Gin had this smoothness, the likes of which I'd never had in any other gin before. I was enjoying the gin. It was an incredible gin with incredible flavours, but it was just this new feature which I'd never experienced before of this gliding sense as it goes down the throat, and it's retained that. So all those things put together, that makes something, wow, something I've absolutely massively enjoyed. Now, as I say, they did recommend it just on the rocks. However, out of my own curiosity, I am going to try it with a bit of tonic as well. Now, this might be blasphemy, I know, but you know, I love a bit of tonic. I love a gin and tonic. So I'm going to try and see what it's like. So here we go. Let's try it. Now, you see, maybe I'm a heathen for doing that. People will be going, you know, Adam, who was responsible for Highclere gin, I'll be going, no, Bobby, you damn fool. But I'm sorry, Adam. I that's going to be my guilty pleasure. I did enjoy it on the rocks, but I tell you what. Ooh, it just kind of, maybe for a bit of a sort of, because I'm a whiskey beginner, I don't generally drink whiskey. That's kind of softening me, giving me an even more kind of gentle slope into the sort of barrel-aged world. But ooh, basically, all the stuff I just said, this slightly sweetens it up slightly and takes that edge off the sort of the whiskey a little bit and slightly less hot. But either way, oh man. That's spectacular. However, my friends, however, is it a spectacular? I don't think that's very politically correct. I'll quickly rephrase that before I get banned from YouTube. Is it a spectacular price? Well, I have to say, it is a bit normal, more than you would normally want to pay. But as I say, this is a limited edition. This is something truly special. So we will pay a little bit more for something like this. It's going to be £99.99, which is, it's a pretty expensive gin. However, this is something that, as it said in the description, is a once in a lifetime chance. So to be honest, if it's once in a lifetime, £99.99 spread over the course of a lifetime is not bad for me, especially when it's something truly, truly spectacular like this little fella. So guys, to sum up, most of all, I'm a bit disappointed my monocle didn't stay in because it took weeks to arrive for that. But however, I'll do it for this last bit maybe. I don't know if you can take me seriously or not. There we go. Oh, for fuck's sake. I wish I hadn't bothered buying the damn thing now. Anyway, to sum up, this, as I say, I was a kind of massively intrigued because it's a different version of my beloved Highclere Castle gin, the best gin I've ever drunk. But part of it was wondering, have they got a little bit too bold now? Have they gone quite mad? Because, you know, it could well have ruined it, because for me, it was perfection. But honestly, they've taken perfection and they've improved upon it. Have improved upon it? They've just added to it and made it a different kind of perfection, because that is, I genuinely enjoyed it, and enjoyed it in a kind of a really sort of a new way, in a way in which, again, I haven't enjoyed gin before, just like the way Highclere Castle did with that silky smoothness. Even if you can't afford this one, it's a bit expensive, don't worry, because there's still the original Highclere Castle gin as well. So these two together, wow. This, you need, if you haven't tried them, get out there and try them, because they're truly excellent. And if you're looking to spend a little bit more money on something that's, as I say, once in a lifetime, this, my friends, has got to be it. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this video today. It was genuinely wonderful to create for you. I hope you enjoyed watching it. If indeed you did, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Press the like button on the video. Head over to my Patreon page if you want to support the show, or indeed, press the button below this video to join my YouTube members. But until next time, guys, you all know the drill. Take care, stay safe. Thank you to all my patrons and members. And of course, keep drinking the gin. How do you do?